Hey there, SkySlopers! In this video, we're going to take a close look at creating checkbox groups. This feature is extremely helpful for disclosure forms that have dozens of options to be selected. Let's dive in. Here we are on the tagging page in DigiSign, the page where you would place any signature or initials onto the document before sending it to be signed. But in this video, we're mostly just going to look at placing checkboxes and creating checkbox groups. Let's start with looking at line 9. To place the checkbox, click on the checkbox option from the toolbar, and then you'll click and drag to place the checkbox onto the document. If you as the sender want to fill in the checkbox, you can select the checked by default option in the left column to check the box, or you can double click into the box to fill it in. If you want to prevent the checkbox from being unchecked by the signer, you will select the read only option. This makes it so that the box can't be edited while signing. And now that we've gone over adding individual checkboxes, let's take a look at creating checkbox groups. For this first example, let's take a look at line 4. You can use checkbox groups to prompt your signer to select a certain number of options within a group. This question has two options, yes and no. So we will first draw a checkbox for the yes option. Once the checkbox is there, click on the plus icon to add another box into that group. Single click onto the second box to select it. Once selected, it can be dragged to a new location. We now have two checkbox options that exist within the same group. And now that we've created the group, we need to set the correct rules for the group. Since we want the signer to select either yes or no, we will set the requirements to select exactly and the number 1. This will ensure that the signer can only select one of the two options. Here's a quick look at those first two checkbox options during the signing process. We can see that for line 4, we're instructed to select one option for either yes or no, and the checkbox we placed for line 9 is there as well. Let's take a look at another section of the property disclosure to see some other checkbox options. On page 3, we have several questions that start with the standard yes/no option and some that have additional options to select. We'll start by creating one checkbox group with two checkboxes and setting the requirements to equal exactly 1. Now that we've created the group, we'll click on the group to select it and then use the copy and paste tools to duplicate it. We can paste the same group anywhere where we want the same options to be available. Since these are all yes/no questions, we can use the same options here. Once we get to line 35, there's a list of 3 options where the signer should select all that apply. We will create a separate checkbox group for these 3 options. After placing the first checkbox, you'll click the plus icon to add the second, and then click the plus icon again to add the 3rd option. The signer will need to select all that apply, which may mean anywhere from selecting 0 options to selecting 3 options. We'll need to set the requirements to at most 3 options. This will make sure that the signer can select up to 3 options when signing. Now let's take a look at this group from the signer's perspective. Each yes/no group is marked as required, and the signer is instructed to select one option. As soon as they've made a selection, they're directed to the next question. For line 35, the signer is directed to select at most 3 boxes, allowing them to select anywhere between 0 and 3. Jumping back over to the sender view, let's look at one more checkbox group option. First, we'll add our standard yes and no group that requires exactly one option be selected. Now we'll add a second group to allow the signer to select the type of water heater. For this group, the signer will need to select one of the 3 options rather than selecting all that apply, so we'll change the requirements to select exactly 1. And let's take a look at that last checkbox group from the signer view. For the group of 3, we're prompted to select just 1, and then we can complete signing. And there you have it! Using checkbox groups is the quickest way to get your documents signed right the first time. Be sure to try them on your next envelope. If you have any questions, reach out to our 24/7 support team. Happy skysloping!